What's up, friends? Welcome to this news style video where we'll be talking about a specific story that the Army is looking to add another badge to the possibilities that a soldier can earn, and this one being the Expert Soldier Badge. And of course, there is a little bit of heat, a little bit of kind of, you know, criticism about this badge. Now first, let's talk a little bit about this badge. It was actually announced back in March that they wanted to do something like this, and they wanted to add a new badge. Back then, they had called it the Expert Action Badge. It has since then changed to the Expert Soldier Badge, or the ESB. Now, so what this is very similar to how the infantry has the EIB, medics have EFMB. You know, these are specific badges that those MOSs can earn to be able to prove that they are maybe in the top 1-2% of their skills and, you know, excel above their other peers. So for EIB, EFMB, there's like a 5-week course, a 5-week type of test that you're having to do that includes like a road march, weapons qualification, a physical fitness test, and a bunch of common soldier tasks like land nav and a lot of other things. And you have to be able to pass that within these certain requirements to be able to earn that badge, either EIB or EFMB. Now for soldiers in other MOSs, they were allowed to say like take like EIB and go and do the EIB course, but if they're not infantry, they don't actually get to wear the EIB even if they completed the whole entire thing and actually qualified for it. So this Expert Soldier Badge is there to kind of fill that so that these individuals do have a course they can go through to try to prove themselves to be above that 1%, 2% area and excel above their peers and hopefully, you know, be able to honor that with an Expert Soldier Badge. Now, a lot of people are criticizing it, saying it's a participation badge, that, you know, all this other kind of thing. Maybe they're upset that, you know, the infantry has their specific badge and this kind of waters that badge down. But the thing is there's still a lot of those same requirements that individuals have to, you know, go through to be able to qualify for EIB that they'll have to do if they want the Expert Soldier Badge. So the Army is saying that 80% of those tasks that individuals have to do in the infantry for EIB, those same tasks are also going to apply to the Expert Soldier Badge. So that means 80% of those same tasks transfer over. The other 20% will be filled with something else. They haven't worked out all the details yet. They're still kind of working on it. But then just to even do this, there are some requirements to even allow a soldier to try to earn this Expert Soldier Badge. Things like they're gonna have to do Army Combat Fitness Test, the new physical fitness test. They're gonna have to do that. Most likely they'll have a certain scoring kind of area that they're gonna have to, you know, reach to be able to qualify for it. It's not just gonna be the bare minimum standards. You know, just simply passing it is not going to be enough. You're probably gonna be like on EIB where you have to score a certain, you know, points in all the events to be able to qualify. You're also gonna have to qualify expert with your rifle. So either M4 or M16, you have to qualify expert. So not just simply qualifying with sharpshooter or marksman is not good enough. Has to be expert. And then one of the third things they're kind of talking about is that your unit actually has to recommend you to be able to attend this this course. So then if you meet those requirements, then you go to this 5-day course that's gonna have a lot of the same events, the road march, the land nav, the basic soldier tasks. And if you are able to meet the standards of that, then you could possibly earn that Expert Soldier Badge. Now they're also saying for this course to go through the Expert Soldier Badge qualification, there is no set standard as far as if you're a certain age or if you're a male or female, if you're a certain MOS, it's just a flat out set standard all across the board for everyone. And now also because 80% of the tasks that you'll have to do to earn the Expert Soldier Badge are the same as EIB, they can easily have these courses, you know, together. So a brigade, a battalion, whatever, could be holding the EIB course, and then those individuals who are trying to earn the Expert Soldier Badge could still jump in to do those tasks, and then for whatever those 20% other tasks are going to be, maybe split off to do those on different days or something. Now you might be asking, why? Why are we doing this? Well, it's essentially to encourage units to push soldiers to work on common soldier tasks, get out of their element. You might be, you know, an individual that is a cook, maybe a mechanic, maybe a finance individual, and you're just set on wanting to just sit behind your desk, work on a truck, whatever the case is, cook some food, whatever, right? But a lot of people lose kind of focus on those basic soldier tasks. If you're in a combat situation and things are really going down, in the long run, you're a soldier and you need to know how to do these common tasks. You know, that spatula, that wrench, that whatever it is that your tool is for your MOS is not going to save you in a combat situation. And it is important to be able to know how to do these combat, these soldier type of skills. And so it encourages those MOSs to get out, do more training and work on those skills so that way you're more than just a cook, you're more than just a mechanic, you're a soldier and you know how to do these soldier tasks. Now, currently it's still kind of being hashed out on how it's going to work. This could go into effect as soon as maybe October, but maybe not until sometime next year. Is what they're gonna have to do is kind of work on the course. They're gonna be utilizing individuals that have already done like EIB or EFMB to kind of basically build this course and be able to validate it to make sure that it's still on par. We don't want to make it to where this expert soldier badge is like the easy badge to obtain. It wants to be on the same kind of level as to the difficulty that it is to obtain the EIB or the EFMB. So that is very important to the Army, is to make sure that this isn't watered down, this isn't a participation badge, and this isn't an easy badge to obtain. It should be still along those same levels as all the other type of badges, the EIB and the EFMB. Now, as far as what it looks like, well, I'll pop it up right here. This is kind of the idea of what it'll most likely look like or possibly look like. It's very similar to the combat action badge, which soldiers can possibly receive in non-combat MOSs if they are kind of engaged by the enemy and they are engaged in some kind of combat situation, then they can earn the combat action badge. And it kind of has that same kind of, you know, distinction, kind of how you have EIB, and then you also have the combat version for infantrymen who are involved in some kind of combat situation to earn the combat infantry badge. So whether that'll be the final version or not, I guess we'll just have to wait and kind of see how this will kind of hash out as far as what skills they'll have to do, what the course will be like, how even it really will be once they get it all hashed out and finalized, and, you know, all the other details, I guess, are going to go along with it. So what are your thoughts on it? I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of people, especially if you're infantry, that maybe don't like this because, like I said, you feel like it's watering down the EIB. Maybe some of you feel that it's a great thing because it allows all soldiers to try to test themselves, to try to excel above and beyond. Me personally, I don't think it hurts anything. I mean, sure, I can understand the point of view from like an infantryman who feels like it's watering it down because now they can't, you know, distinguish, you know, something specifically above the rest, you know, as from infantry compared to a mechanic or whatever, you know, another MOS, right? So I can kind of see that point of view, but I feel like this is great to encourage soldiers to get outside of their element and push themselves to excel above their other peers that are simply just, you know, going with the motions and doing their job. All right, so if you enjoyed this news video, go ahead and slap a thumbs up on the video. If you want to check out a recommended video, I got one right over there from the last news episode that I did. I'm Christopher Chaos. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. See ya.